Hey everybody, Jay Super Awesome here. I'd like to welcome you all to week number 25 of the Horror Man Slashback Saturday Challenge. This week's slasher movie theme is College Slashers, and I will be giving my review for Rush Week. Okay, so getting into the plot for this one. Rush Week. Frat parties and outrageous pranks are happening all over Tambers College in California. But a homicidal maniac lurks amid the craziness, and college girls are disappearing faster than beers at a kegger. Tony is a newly transferred journalism student searching for her big story when fellow student Julie turns up dead after posing for a mysterious photographer. Tony thinks she's found her killer lead. As more girls are murdered, Tony receives an anonymous warning to let the matter drop. Then, Jeff, the president of the Beta Delta Beta fraternity, begins acting strangely. What does it all mean? In the shocking finale, Tony discovers the killer and gets her story, a much bigger story than she could have imagined. Hang on to your pledge pin and don't close your eyes. It's Rush Week. Okay, so getting into my thoughts for this one. Rush Week is a slasher movie that I have always had fond memories of. I remember when it was originally released, I remember going to the video store with my parents at a pretty young age, seeing it on the shelf, and I remember having the excitement of discovering a brand new slasher movie, at least brand new for the time. This is definitely a slasher movie that I enjoyed much more at a younger age. Now, I still do own that VHS tape. I actually bought it when they put it on sale, so that is pretty cool. So Rush Week is a movie that will always hold a lot of nostalgia for me. I clearly remember that time period of my life. So when this week's Slashback Challenge was revealed to be a college slasher movie, I knew immediately that I was going to be reviewing Rush Week. I was really excited about the opportunity and the push, I guess, to rewatch this movie. So with all that excitement and all that nostalgia, what could possibly go wrong? I had already stated that this is a slasher movie that I enjoyed much more at a younger age. I came away from it this time a little disappointed. The movie's runtime is 100 minutes long, and it uses the biggest majority of that time to set up misdirection, trying to keep you guessing who the killer is. This is a by-the-book slasher movie, and even though I have seen this multiple times throughout my lifetime, I couldn't imagine anybody watching this movie and not being able to figure out who the killer is. I felt like the movie had a really good college atmosphere to it. There were a lot of parties being thrown with some bands playing in the background, so some really good 80s style music. There were a lot of pranks being played between the fraternities. Well, that was really cool. So overall, the college atmosphere of this movie is definitely a plus. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about the cast of characters that we have in Rush Week. Unfortunately, I'm not the biggest fan of the characters that we have in this movie. Our lead character, she is a recently transferred reporter, and she's always kind of snooping around looking for a scoop. Quickly after she settles in at the new school, she is starting to hear about some of the college girls going missing. So that is her immediate focus for a story. Now, I totally understand her doing that, with it being her job or the career that she is pursuing in journalism. She just really wasn't that interesting of a character. And when your main character of the story isn't that interesting, then that's a major problem. Some of the characters that I did enjoy in this movie are some of the side characters that we really don't get to spend a whole lot of time with, but they are some of the characters that are just basically enjoying life. They're having a good time. It's always about a party to them, and they're always having fun. They are the ones doing the pranks. Those kind of characters I was really enjoying in this movie. There was one guy that was always lurking in the background, and he was a very familiar actor. Now, I didn't look up his name, because even if I did, I probably wouldn't even be able to pronounce it right. He was Joey in Friday the 13th, Part 5. He was the guy that was trying to offer Vic the candy bar and got himself axed up to all the pieces. That guy's in this movie. He was also the director of Evil Laugh, but he always just seems to be in the background of this movie. And he does have one or two lines of dialogue in this movie, and that's about it. A lot of you slasher movie fans will know who I'm talking about. And also, another person that makes a cameo appearance sort of in this movie is Kelly from Halloween Part 4. And she's also Gloria in Bride of the Reanimator. And I also did not look her name up because I don't really like attempting to pronounce people's names badly. But I do know a lot of you slasher movie enthusiasts will recognize these two characters in this movie. Okay, so getting into the most important part of a slasher movie, that is the killer and the kills. Absolutely love the look of the killer in this movie. We have yet again another cloaked killer, this time using the old man's mask. It's very reminiscent of the hag mask that was used in the classic slasher film, Curtains. All besides, this time, it is the old man's mask that's being used. So it's really cool looking, and I think the killer has a very effective look for this movie. The reveal of who the killer is pretty typical and not really a exciting moment in the movie for me. Still, overall, it was okay. This killer does have a weapon of choice, and it is pretty much a battle axe that he chooses to kill off his victims with. Speaking of kills, this is a pretty low body count movie, especially for its runtime. The first two kill sequences are very similar. The first kill sequence, we do get a good stalk scene, and when the killer comes face to face with his first victim, he simply raises the axe and goes into a swinging motion, and we get a quick cut. And that's pretty much what happens in the second kill sequence. We get a swinging motion, and then it goes into a quick cut. We don't get to see the ending results of the kills or any kind of blood or any kind of gore or anything. The last 20 minutes of the movie does pick up a little bit, and we do get a little bit of blood and gore. There's not really a lot in this movie, and that's kind of unfortunate for its runtime. With all that being said, I still enjoy this movie. I don't enjoy it as much as I once did, but I do still find quite a bit of entertainment value to this one. I'm going to give it a 6.5 out of 10. Please like, subscribe, comment below. Let me know if you have seen Rush Week, or just let me know what you think about my review. And I would like to thank you all for watching.